Welcome back. Well, everyone knows if you're looking for the truest way to have your arrow fly, there's no better way than putting a feather on the back of that arrow. And look no further than Gateway Feathers. Now, I'm here with Todd. Todd, tell us about your company, Gateway Feathers, and why your feathers are the best.
Well, I can tell you that we spend a lot of time and effort just working on the QC of the feather, of taking that feather and taking it from a full-length feather, like you may see behind us, to these cut pieces that you'll see right here today. We spend a lot of time and energy making that full-length feather into a cut piece to go to the consumer.
Now you're saying you can make that into a cut piece. You do all styles of feathers also, correct?
I could fill a book with the many styles of feathers that we have available, but right here today is just a small sampling of what we have of shields, parabolic, full lengths, cut sections, and of course our razor feather that is made for compound users, being shot out of a fast compound bow, 300 feet per second or more. The razor feather is an excellent little feather for you.
And that's an excellent point. A lot of those compound bow shooters think, oh, the only thing I can shoot because I'm shooting a compound bow is the plastic feathers, and that is a fallacy.
You're exactly right. A feather weighs much less than a piece of plastic, which allows you to have a faster, flatter shooting arrow at distance. Comes out of your bow faster. If you're shooting more than 60 yards, I mean, you need to be using a feather.
You look at the way the feathers flow through the air. That's why they're a natural product. These are all natural feathers to start with.
Exactly right. You know, turkeys, these are turkey feathers. They're all brought together. They're all processed in the United States. And then we gather them from different processing plants and then bring them to Arizona and have them processed.
And one of the other nice things about them being a natural feather is you have the natural left and right helical curve to the feather.
That is true. And if you're wondering about that whole issue about if I'm right-handed, do I need a right-handed feather, or if I'm left-handed, do I need a left-handed feather, you don't need to worry about that. All you need to know is the type of jig that you have, the clamp that you have. If it's a left-wing clamp, then you need to use a left-wing feather. If it's a right-wing clamp, you need to use a right-wing feather. If it isn't marked, it's generally straight, and that means you could use either or.
Now, also, a lot of people think, well, geez, now these feathers, they're not going to be waterproof. Plastic feathers, that's the only thing I can use in the rain or any kind of inclement weather. That's wrong also.
Well, you're exactly right again. We do have waterproofing powder, and the powder, when it's applied correctly, when you take that feather and pull it back and get that powder down in between the barbules of the feather, it just sheds water. You can stand out in the rain, and your feathers will not lay down. You'll have excellent flight from your feathers. And some of the things that we do to help both consumers and retailers is have YouTube videos, instructional videos out there that show you how to apply that kind of powder to the feathers so that you can better use that product.
And now talking about that powder, you obviously sell that powder also.
Yes, sir. Gateway Feathers waterproofing powder.
And the glue to attach these?
The glue to it. You know, we have a bunch of different accessories, and whether it's feather tracers, DVDs, instructional DVDs, how-to DVDs on shooting correctly. We try to be a one-stop shop for all the dealers and retailers out there.
Now, I'm looking at all your feathers. You have some fantastic designs on these, some I've never seen before. How is all that taking place?
A lot of it is, a digital age now, Bob, and we're able to do things with machinery that we couldn't many years ago. And so the prints, our new product, now we can take and put peacock eyes on feathers. We can put tiger stripes on feathers. We can even go and put Gateway Feathers, our logo, and a name, or if a retailer would like their logo and a name on a feather.
That's a fantastic idea.
Well, it's turned out to be very popular, yes, sir.
And one of the nice things about these, you get a pack of these feathers, you shoot one, you might damage one of the fletches on your arrow. It's very easy to, if you've got the right jig, which you've probably started out with, razor blade that one off, glue another one, and you're ready to go.
It does become very easy, yes, sir, and that's the beauty of a feather. Even if you're missing a small portion of it, it doesn't affect the total flight of the arrow. You can be missing a small portion and still have good arrow flight with feathers, and it won't be as noisy.
Well, Todd, right now, I know you've got the attention of all of our viewers. They want to know how they can get some more information on feathers and why they are the best and how they can get the best feathers on their arrow. How can they get some more information?
It's easy, Bob. You got to go to www.gatewayfeathers.com.
Hey, if you're looking for the best arrow, the best flight arrow, you got to get a Gateway Feather.
There you go. I agree, Bob.
Hey, Todd, thanks so much for being on the show. I really appreciate it.
It was a lot of fun. Thank you.
Thank you.